And in this video, we're going to learn... Oh, this is embarrassing. Okay, one moment. What? Yes, Maddie? Yeah, I'm recording a... No JS intervention? Yeah, hair extension. All right, but I'm about... A VS Code extension? Are you sure? I can announce this right now. All right, thank you. So this just in, we have an official VS Code extension that will allow you to build .NET MAUI apps with VS Code. Let's go check it out right now. Yes, you've heard it right. There is now an official Microsoft VS Code extension that will allow you to develop your .NET MAUI apps on any platform that is supported by VS Code, basically. So at the time of recording, a couple of weeks ago, the C# dev kit was released, which was really an amazing extension already, which brings a feature-rich experience to VS Code for developing C# projects, C# and .NET projects. So you could get all kinds of crazy things like the Solution Explorer, the Test Explorer that you're used to from full Visual Studio. You will get Roslyn analyzer stuff, AI powered goodness. So all this good stuff bringing over from Visual Studio full so that the experience for developing .NET projects and C# projects is also an amazing experience on VS Code. Now, on top of that, we've built the .NET MAUI extension. So now with the .NET MAUI extension, you can also build your .NET MAUI apps on Windows, on macOS, and also, yes, I'm going to say it, on Linux. Well, more on that a little bit later. So we have this extension, which is really cool. It brings a couple of those extra things that are in Visual Studio full. I just keep it naming it Visual Studio full, like selecting your emulator and your simulator. Of course, some IntelliSense as well. The XAML editing experience is a little bit lightweight. We'll see that. But let's just stop talking about it and show you, because I'm sure you're excited to try it out yourself. So I'm just going to give you the highlights, and then I'm going to let you go and explore for yourself. Let's hop over. So not in Visual Studio 2022 this time, but in Visual Studio Code, I have the Insiders version, which is kind of like the preview version of VS Code, but this works for the regular stable version of VS Code as well. So here I have the extension. If you go to the extensions pane on the left here, you can find .NET MAUI in the store. I have it already installed, so it's under installed for me, but you can find it, this fancy logo. Click the install button and it will bring in everything that you need. Well, it will bring in the extension, so the C# dev kit, if you don't have that already, and all the extension that it depends upon, it will bring that in, but it won't set up like your entire environment for like Android specifically. It won't install all the prerequisites like you might have been familiar with full VS Studio, Visual Studio, because that's just not how VS Code kind of like works, I guess. But more on that in a little bit. So here is a full description. I'm not going to read anything. I'll just give you the important bits. So here is this feature list, and here are the supported kind of like platforms. So there is one important thing different from Visual Studio full. For Windows, you could typically connect to your Mac build host, which could be on the network, and you could build your iOS applications on your Windows machine. That's not possible with this VS Code extension yet, hopefully. I hope something like that will come. But for now, you can see this kind of like matrix here. So we have Windows, and you can deploy to Windows and Android. When you're running VS Code on macOS, you can deploy to Android, iOS, and macOS. And when you run on Linux, because VS Code runs on Linux, you can deploy to Android. So just to be very, very clear, you cannot write .NET MAUI apps that will run on Linux, but you can open your VS Code on Linux, and you can write apps on Android, right? So you can now do cross-platform development, at least starting with Android, on Linux as well. That is very new. Now, not the most fun thing to talk about, but some known limitations. So the XAML editing capabilities, I already mentioned them, a little lightweight, like the, we all know the XAML by heart, right? So we can just type it and it will, of course, work, but it will not do all the code completions and IntelliSense and that kind of stuff. It's being worked on and we will improve that in future releases. This is a preview release right now. You can switch the target framework for IntelliSense. So I might show you that in a little bit, but if you have like in full Visual Studio, you have that combo box now, that drop-down box, which will allow you to switch the context between the platforms. So if you want to have IntelliSense specific for iOS, then you select iOS there and it will give you that. That doesn't work yet for VS Code. It's coming. We're working on it. But right now, if you really need that IntelliSense, just go into your CS Proj, into the target frameworks tag, and move the framework that you want to see the IntelliSense for to the front of the list, and you will get the IntelliSense for that. If I remember, I will show you that in a little bit. XAML and .NET Hot Reload aren't supported yet. We're working on that. And the extension has not been fully tested with iOS and Xcode betas. So we have the betas right now for iOS 17 at the time of recording. We didn't fully test it with that. So make sure that you're using the stable ones or use it with the betas and let us know if it actually works already. That would be super cool. Now, if you found a bug, we're doing this for you and with you, and we appreciate all the feedback. You can also report it through VS Code, also for this extension, which is really cool. So you can go to help and then report an issue. And then you can choose here, bug report, feature request, performance issue, and you can select the source. So if you have anything in Visual Studio Code, definitely report that as well. But if you want it for this extension, do an extension, click the .NET MAUI one, and now you can enter a title and a description, and we will get all the information to hopefully get it fixed soon. So now with that out of the way, let's just see whenever you install it, what is going to happen. So let's close this extensions pane and this overview, and you will get this great walkthrough tutorial. So I'm not going to walk you through all the steps. Like I said, there is some more manual steps if you have not set up .NET MAUI on your machine. So if you have installed a VS Full, whether on macOS or on Windows, it should mostly just work because that have brought in all the prerequisites. But otherwise, this will walk you through all the steps. So if you have a clean machine, you just install VS Code, this will walk you through all the steps. If you can't figure it out, please let me know down in the comments and I'll make a follow-up video where I walk you through it in more detail. First, we have to connect our C# dev kit account, so click connect. My account is already connected. You can see a little pop-up here coming up in the bottom right. Else it will pop up a browser window. You have to log in with your account because this is tied to C# dev kit. So this will follow the same licenses as full Visual Studio. So you can use it for free. Visual Studio Community is for free. If you have a company license for Visual Studio, you can log in with that account and you should be able to just use it. Check, we've got that. Set up your .NET environment. So if we go to that, it will make you check your .NET version. You can click here to create a new terminal, do .NET version, see what you got installed. You can even click the install .NET SDK button here and actually install it from right there. I'm pretty sure that I got it set up, so I have it. Set up your .NET MAUI environment, so you can open a terminal and check your .NET workload list. So actually, let me do that. I'm gonna copy this right here, open a terminal. It will open the integrated terminal of VS Code, and I can just copy .NET workload list, and it will show me a couple of MAUI options. I already got that set up. If you don't see anything here, there is the command right here at the top, which says .NET workload install MAUI. That will bring in all the bits. Or if you're running on Windows, it's still kind of like the preferred method right now to install the Visual Studio IDE. Check the .NET MAUI workload, and that will bring in all the dependencies right here. If you're on a Mac, also make sure that you have Xcode, right? So this will walk you through it. Create your .NET MAUI app. So now we can create our first .NET MAUI app. You can go into a console, you can do .NET new MAUI, or you can just do it from here inside of Visual Studio. So let's do that. You will get this command palette. That's what it's called in Visual Studio Code. Create new project, and you see all the templates, well, a couple of the templates for C# and .NET, and now you also see the .NET MAUI and .NET MAUI Blazor ones. So let's just click this one, go into a new folder. I'm going to create a new one, MAUI VS Code, go into this folder, select folder, and it's going to ask me to name my project, so MAUI App 1, that's fine, and it's going to create this project now for me. It's going to reload this VS Code window, and it's going to open this MAUI app for me. I trust the authors. Yes, I'm a very trustworthy person. And now we have this MAUI app 1. It's open for us. Now, there is a bug for me because I'm using an internal version, else I couldn't get you this video on time. But I think in the version that you're going to see, this bug should be solved because I have a solution file here right now, which is named after the folder that I just created. And I have a subfolder which also has a solution file, which is kind of like 2, which is not great. You shouldn't have to do that. VS Code was very helpful, though. I'm going to get myself out of the way. It popped me a notification with like, hey, there is multiple solution files. Which one do you want to open? So I chose one to open. Just go with this MAUI app 1, and it's going to open that solution. And now you can see Visual Studio Code has this bunch of folders, just a tree view with the files and folders in there. But now we also have the Solution Explorer, which looks more like how you're used to with Visual Studio Full, right? So you have the solution, you have the project, and under that you will have the dependencies and all the folders and the XAML files and the CS files. So we got all that, and I can go into this XAML. We will get the highlighting and stuff, but we will not get the IntelliSense yet. So if I want to do this background color, this won't really work yet, but of course we know everything from the top of our head, so we can just add this background color. Now, what's really cool is that we can just run this. So we have everything right here. The editing and everything is just as you're used to. So what I can do now is go over to my run and debug pane, and I can just say, hey, run and debug, or you can press F5. And it will come up with like the options. Hey, what profile you want to run with? Oh, actually that happened before, but now it remembered that I want to do this with the .NET MAUI profile. Else you would get the command palette and it would say like, hey, what do you want to run this with? And you say .NET MAUI, and now it's going to run the Windows target by default, and it's going to deploy the application, and my Windows application is going to come up, and I can debug through it if I want to and do all the things, well, not all the things, but a lot of the things that are also in the full Visual Studio, but now from the lightweight editor that is Visual Studio Code. So that is very, very cool. You can see the debug console, all the output is coming by, my application is coming up, and I can just go through this. I can go back to Visual Studio Code, my main page, the code behind, set a little breakpoint here, click this button again, and boom, we are landing in our breakpoint, and I can walk through this, I can inspect the variables here, you can do all these things. So one thing that is not really easy to discover is the selection of like the emulators and where you want to run to. So if I get out of the way here again, here in the status bar, you can see already Windows local machine, by default this is not there. You have to click the curly brackets right here, and when you want to have easier access, then you want to click this pin right here. So if I don't do that, you just have this, and you can select the debug target. And if you click the pin, it will be a little bit more clear and easier accessible here from this status bar right here. And you can click it, and that will bring up the command palette again. And you can go through these pixel and that kind of stuff, right? So you can see all the devices here that are connected to your machine and actually select the one that you want to run on. And what's really cool, it's just one of those very small wins, but now, especially if you are running on iOS, you have like a gazillion list of all the iOS simulators, right? Or you could have that. Now you can filter through it, something you couldn't do before. So if I just start typing pixel, you see all the pixels, right? So I can just select one of these. It's just a very small thing that comes free with VS Code basically, but this is very helpful to me. So you can just switch over to the pixel one, start running that one, and you have the same thing. So there is that. The last thing before I hop over to macOS and just show you how it works there is I want to show you how to get the IntelliSense for a different framework. So go back to your files and go into your CSproj file right here. So this is what I meant. Now we would get the IntelliSense for Android specifically first. If you want to have it for iOS, just make sure that you get this one for iOS and put that in front of the list. Save it. It will reload your project. And now we will have the iOS IntelliSense at the front, right? So that's all that. Now let's quickly hop over to macOS and see how it works there. So here we are on macOS, and you can see it looks the exact same. So this is very boring. VS Code looks the exact same on all the platforms, so that's really cool. Here I'm also running on dark mode, so it also works on dark mode. It has dark mode support, yay! And the thing that I didn't just really mention is that you can also select your emulators and your devices in another way and trigger some more functionality. If you press Command P or Control P on Windows, you will get this command palette, right? You can go through the files. This is really your best friend if you learn how to work with VS Code. So go look up those VS Code tutorials, or let me know down in the comments if you want to see more content on that. But you can not only skip to files and do all kinds of amazing stuff with this, you can also trigger commands. You just type an angle bracket, and now you're suddenly going to execute commands right here. And you can prefix it with the extension name, so you have to do MAUI, or you can do .NET MAUI. It will filter the list. And now you see all the commands that have to do with the .NET MAUI extension, like pick iOS device. So you can pick your devices like this, or configure Android. So if you're starting from scratch and you need some help with, oh, what should I do to set up my Android environment? Do this. It will bring you to the next steps, and you can learn more and set all these things up just to get you started. But you can also select all these things. So pick the Android device, pick iOS device, and it will already filter it to those devices. So if I do iOS device right now, you can see that it has all these devices. And this is what I meant. This is like a long list, right? But now what I can do is say iPhone 14 Pro, and there you have it, iPhone 14 Pro. I can go back to running here, run my .NET MAUI profile. It starts building all the things, and it will come up with the iPhone 14 Pro simulator, and you can actually run and debug all the same things that you're used to, like with Visual Studio for Mac, but now from VS Code. So this is how to get started with VS Code in .NET MAUI and all the things. I don't even know what I'm saying anymore. Let's just close this video and let you explore for yourself. You might be able to tell that I'm a tiny bit excited about all of this, because I think this is great. People have been asking for this since forever, and now it's finally here. You can develop .NET MAUI apps in this lightweight, great editor that everyone loves, VS Code. So go get that extension. It's out right now as you're watching this video, so go get it. There's also a blog post that explains all of this and a documentation page. Actually, it's a documentation page of regular .NET MAUI, so just go to learn.microsoft.com/.NET/MAUI, and there you will now find new tab with the Getting Started for Visual Studio Code, which list all the things that you should know about this. If you can't figure something out, let me know down in the comments below. That will be feedback that I can bring back to the team, but also I'm going to try and help you out to get started with this. Please let us know what you think about this VS Code extension. I think it's super duper cool. Just don't even watch a next video from my channel this time, just this once, and go check out this VS Code extension. See you for the next one.